Hey everybody, Abby Normal here, and today I want to talk to you guys a little bit about words and the differences between American and British words. Most of my audience is from America. Hi everybody, America. A lot of you, more than likely, speak to people from the UK. Hey UK guys. I thought that I would try to facilitate a better dialogue between America and the UK by giving some differences when it comes to slang. One of the things you're going to need to know is the word bum. So you may already know, you Americans, that bum is the word for butt. But you may not know that bumming around Europe or bumming around the house has a completely different meaning in the UK than it does here. Anal sex. For the British people, there's something that really confuses you. We do have jam in America. Jam. See? Black raspberry jam. Made from sugar and pureed fruit. Jelly. Apple jelly. Made from fruit juice and pectin, or sometimes gelatin. But pectin is in here, not in here. Made from fruit, made from fruit juice. That's the difference. Fanny in the UK, it means the vagina. Fanny in the US means the butt. Okay? So when you go to the UK, do not call the little satchel that you wear on your stupid belt a fanny pack. That's bad. Don't call it that. It is a bum bag. In the UK, you should also be very careful about the word chug, because I can tell you right now that chugging doesn't really necessarily mean to drink very quickly. It means masturbation. Bollocks is balls. They can be either good or bad. If you say, that was bollocks, it means it's bad. But if you say, that's the dog's bollocks, well, that means it's good. There is a distinction in the UK between arse and ass. An ass is an animal. An arse is your butt. In America, there isn't a distinction between the two of them. Pavement in the UK is a pedestrian walkway that's between the buildings and the road. In the US, of course, it's called a sidewalk. Chav. In the UK, there's a thing called a chav. A chav is a hoodlum who kind of wears typically like a jogging outfit, like a tracksuit, or a wannabe gangster kind of thing. Ned is a non-educated delinquent, often looking like a chav. In Scotland, an older version of a Ned would be a bam, and that's people who are older than a teen who basically act like Neds. In the UK, if you ask for the restroom, more than likely you'll get an incredibly strange look. They don't call bathrooms restrooms or even the bathroom. They call them toilet. So when you say you need the toilet, or would you'd like to know where the toilets are, you ask, where are the ladies and where are the gents? In the US, you would say restroom. It's considered kind of nasty to say toilet. It's ugly, an ugly word. Bugger. In America, it's kind of considered cute or not very offensive to call somebody a nasty little bugger. In the UK, don't call someone a bugger. Bugger is anal sex. Sodomy. No! Knackered. In the UK, if you're feeling tired, you would say knackered, completely without energy. You've nothing left to give. In America, you would just say, I'm beat. Faff. Faff is a British word meaning to just kind of goof off, to waste time. In America, you might say you're dinking around, you're dinking off. Or you might also say in the UK, to fanny about. Gutted. Gutted means you're completely disappointed. you're really sad about something. I hope that these were helpful to you guys. I might do one in the future if you guys really liked this. And I hope that you have a good day!